Okay, lay down on a couch and tell us what you see. How about this one? Maybe a dragon being eaten by a pig? This is, I don't know, an old man? I think I see a nose in there. No, they are in fact congressional districts.
Over the past year, the Supreme Court, in more than one case, has tackled gerrymandering.
The Supreme Court has long told states they must draw lines that provide for equal populations. One person, one vote.
Trickery, they don't go for it.
Yeah. There's some trickery in there. Wait a minute, hold on.
I was part of that lawsuit for Covington versus North Carolina about their districts based on race. Had to go all the way to the Supreme Court to make North Carolina get some sense, right? You heard it at church. What church you go to?
Friendship Mission of Baptist.
Okay.
Well, Pastor is very much into the political arena, even though he's a spiritual man.
So what did he say about the redistricting? What did he say?
Oh, he thought it was very much needed.
That's right. People are starting to not only understand gerrymandering in theory and concept, but they're starting to understand how it impacts their lives.
Let's see. Crooked line.
I didn't even bring my maps with me.
Crooked line.
Oh, the really was zigzag.
Yeah.
Could go in real and come right.
Yeah.
And miss you.
I've served 20 plus years in the military fighting for democracy. And I thought that inherently, gerrymandering was egregious to the democratic principles of this country. The Covington case was a lawsuit brought by citizens in North Carolina. We all came together to say that our districts were drawn illegally based on race. In the June timeframe, we expect to hear from the Supreme Court. I am hopeful that they will see that in North Carolina, there is a problem.
So it's my job to kick off this conference by framing the problem overall. Okay, so let's just start with the classic, how to gerrymander. The simplest principle is if you want to win one district, you arrange the placement of the lines just so you get more votes than anybody else. When plurality wins, you want the plurality. You just want the most votes.
So who draws the maps? By default, it's going to be the legislature. The legislature is now empowered to draw the lines for their own re-election. We have access to voter data that's meticulously detailed. So if you're in charge and you know where all the people are and you know everything you might possibly want to know about them, that gives you surgical precision in the creation of maps.
And so you start to see districts that are a little bit more eccentric looking. Bad shapes are a tip-off to some kind of agenda.
North Carolina is ground zero for a lot of the racial gerrymandering. News comes out every day here. So this seemed like a great place to come to bring together local experts who've been thinking about different sides of the problem. At its simplest, racial gerrymandering is just drawing the lines in order to dilute the voting power of a minority, of a racial minority.
When you look at the geographic boundary of Hope County, Senate District 21, which is in Burgundy, and then we have another map here in 19 in green, Cumberland County, and when you see these tentacles, these, you know, like octopus arms reaching into another county, and you know that those Burgundy areas bring in minority communities. Hope County 21 reaches all the way into the most historic African-American communities in Cumberland County. So the whole concept of gerrymandering and packing African-Americans into districts is reflected here.
The
The U.S. Supreme Court today said race played too much of a role in the drawing of 28 legislative districts.
The High Court ruled unanimously that state lawmakers wrongly packed African Americans into 28 districts to limit their power.
But for voters, this means that about half the state, mostly in the central regions, will see their state legislative districts redrawn.
That was amazing when we got the email. I was like, wait, what? Like, we really did do this.
One interesting thing that we're watching around the country is the success that people have in shaming their representatives in cases of the most egregious gerrymanders. And that's something that seems to be working better in North Carolina than in other hotspot states.
People power, together we will stand and reclaim our rights with voting right across this troubled land.
Something is happening here that the nation can learn from. This is about whether a government of the people and by the people will in fact serve the people, because we've got an unconstitutionally constituted General Assembly because of racially gerrymandered, unconstitutional districts.
The Supreme Court directed the North Carolina legislature to redraw the maps. You know, I don't think just because the Supreme Court directed them to redraw them that all of a sudden people in Raleigh are going to have a conscience and say, oh yeah, well, we were kind of wrong. Well, late last night, they they released the new maps. I'll let you be the judge. How much of this has changed? Yeah, maybe a couple little fingers were cut off or whatever, but there is really not much different. When these maps were drawn as they are, it was done like in a little room. No one knew what was going on. And then it's like, ta-da, here are the maps.
When legislatures are operating under cover of obscurity, they can do almost anything. But when the citizenry is activated and is paying attention, that constrains those abuses.
We're trying to mobilize citizens. You pay attention, come out to the hearings, and have your voices heard.
Our hearing tonight is so that we can hear from you and your input on the districts themselves. Besides this location here in Raleigh, we have six satellite locations.
We deserve fair voting maps that are drawn by a nonpartisan redistricting commission.
They turned around and hired the very consultant who drew the previous racist gerrymandered maps.
The definition of insanity is to do the same thing over and over and over again and expect different results.
What we need are legislators who reflect the moral code upon which our nation was built. I'm calling on you now to repent and to clean up your act.
Adelante, junto, ni un paso atrás. Forward together, not one step back.
We say this is what democracy looks like. Today, people showed up to have their voices heard. It's just a matter of what, it's a matter of our legislators respect democracy.
Legislative voting maps have been redrawn again, this time by an outside expert.
The federal judges that are reviewing the state's legislative maps don't believe Republican lawmakers fix problems with racial bias.
So they appointed what's known as a special master, a Stanford professor named Nathan Persily, to redraw some of those districts again.
So post the United States Supreme Court direction, the master, special master, was appointed and drew new maps. Here you have the result of the efforts from the special master. We still have Senate District 21 and you have Senate District 19, but what is missing are the appendages that stuck all the way out into Cumberland County. So that's what we have. We're pleased with the outcome of the special master.
My thought and hope is that the era of the most shameless gerrymandering is probably ending. What's so exciting about this problem is that you can make math work for justice. We run these training sessions that I hope give people the skills on the ground to make their own maps, to analyze existing maps. The more you democratize the power to build maps, the better traction you get against this problem.
I think it's made the districts more competitive, and African American voters can influence the outcome of the race.
And tan and red and brown, to say that we're not gonna let the fascists beat us down. Oh, we fought and died for voting rights, a right we cannot lose, and the right of women still to plan our families as we choose. Our people we will stand and reclaim our rights with all our might across this troubled land.